Alright, today we're going to be doing a Honda valve adjustment. We have a 2007 Honda Civic, also known as a 8th generation Honda. So we're going to be doing a valve adjustment on an 8th generation Honda. Right now I'm just pulling the valve cover off. Relatively easy job in this vehicle. The only parts you're really going to need is a valve cover gasket and a few basic tools, a 10mm wrench, some socket, 19mm socket to turn the crank with. You have a couple bolts holding that wiring harness down. Those are just 10mm bolts. There's four valve cover bolts in the front, and there's also going to be another four 10mm valve cover bolts in the back. I'm going to remove the airbox here just to get a little better access to everything. This is just a little plastic cover that sits on the back of the valve cover. It kind of protects the fuel injectors. We're going to be adjusting the intake and the exhaust valves on this. The exhaust valves are in the front where the exhaust manifold is, and the intakes are on the back where the intake manifold is. Right now I'm just cleaning it down with brake clean, then I'm going to spray it off to make sure no dirt or grime gets inside the motor when I pull the valve cover. This valve adjustment procedure also works on many different types of Hondas or many different types of engines. Basically, the valve adjustment procedure will vary slightly, but I mean, for the most part, adjusting valves on most vehicles is relatively the same process. Here I'm just checking by hand to see if there's any play, and as you can see there, that one's got quite a bit of play in it. I'm going to throw a picture up here on the valve specs, what they need to be adjusted to, in a minute. And you're just going to need a feeler gauge and a 10mm wrench and a screwdriver to do that. These are the valve specs and the cylinder. Now we're just going to rotate our crank until we bring the cam marks to which cylinder we want to adjust the valves on. Cylinder 1 is going to have the up symbol like this. So now we're going to adjust the intake and exhaust valves for cylinder 1, as you see in the picture. Okay, here I'm adjusting the exhaust valves, and I'm going to set these to 0.25 millimeters. Then once you get the valves adjusted, you do want to torque these 10mm bolts down to 10 foot-pounds or 14 newton-meters. And we're adjusting the valves on a 1.8-liter Honda Civic today. Basically, you just want, once you get this adjusted properly, that feeler gauge should just slightly, you should have just a slight amount of drag on that. But you should still be able to move it. So once you get that adjusted down, just torque your bolt and move on to the next one. We're going to move to cylinder 2 on the crank there. So we're going to turn until that says 2. And then we're going to adjust the intake and exhaust valves for cylinder 2, which are going to be these four. The front two here, which are your exhaust valves, and the rear two that are your intake valves. And here's the picture again. So we'll be doing the number 2. And so forth. We're going to go to number 3 and do the same thing. Two intakes and two cylinder number 3 exhaust valves right there. Last but not least, cylinder 4, and there's a mark on the camshaft sprocket. So again, I'm just turning the crank through the wheel well with a 19mm socket on this one. Just turning it by hand. until I get to cylinder number 4. On some of the older model Hondas, it's going to be a 17 millimeter socket. You're going to need to turn that crank. So, we got this one set to cylinder 4, so we're going to move on to the last cylinder and adjust those 4 valves. Do the 2 intake valves here. 1, 2. And then the 2 exhaust valves in the back. 1, 2. And I'm just going to show you again here how I'm feeling. You know, I just want a slight bit of drag on that feeler gauge. And then I'm going to lock it down and torque them to 10 foot-pounds. So we're ready to put this thing back together now. Like I said, pretty much the only parts you're going to need to do this job is a valve cover gasket. I'm putting that in now. Just make sure your valve cover is nice and clean. You got your gasket seated in all the way. You're going to need some RTV or some kind of gasket maker, because there's 2 spots on the engine block that you're going to need to apply this, where the timing cover meets the cylinder head. Alright, so we're ready to get this thing back together. Alright, I got my Honda valve adjustment all done here. I'm just going to finish it off here by, you know, making it look kind of nice. Just going to spray a little WD-40 on there, wipe it down, make it look good for the customer. And that about does it for our Honda Civic 8th generation valve adjustment, or Honda valve adjustment video. If this was useful in any way, be sure to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, Flat Rate Mechanics.